Okay guys, and welcome, Professor Slater here. With online classes happening, I feel like it's a good tip to share to you how I learn things, or basically, how I learn absolutely anything. I read a lot, I read about a book a month, generally. I have to teach things to the people that I manage, my wife, I teach things to my wife sometimes. Ako din yung tinuturuan niya. These are the things that we will be talking about at the end of this video so that we can simplify a lot of things that is taught to us in school. And we're gonna discuss civil engineering, the very basics, just by using a spaghetti stick. And that's why we are in the kitchen. Okay, linguini, kasi social si wife. And naubos yung spaghetti stick namin sa the other video. Anyway, the very basics of engineering, whether you're in architecture, mechanical engineering, civil engineering, and a lot of the engineering courses is strength of materials, or tinatawag nilang mechanics of materials. And it is defined as the strength of a material is its ability to withstand an applied load without failure or plastic deformation. So ang hirap, di ba? But basically, civil engineering or strength of materials is just how to break the spaghetti. The different ways you can break the spaghetti or deform it. That's it. Second, merong mga subcategories there. What are these things that break the spaghetti? Firstly, moment. Okay, let's search moment. Moment in engineering mechanics. Hirap. Ito from MIT. The moment of a force
is a measure of its tendency to cause a body to rotate about a specific point or axis.
Oh my god, I can remember the times. This is one of the very basics talaga of civil engineering, and we would compute this, and I did not know what it was talking about. I knew the formula, I knew how to do the equations, the analyzing, the charts and everything. But hindi pumasok sa akin kung ano talaga ang moment. But essentially guys, moment is just bending. Bending until this bends, or bending until this breaks. That's it. Ang mga formulas dyan would equate into, it's easier to bend it from here, and it's harder to bend it from here. That's it. Very quickly, moment. Then there is tension. Boring na siya, no?
You're so into it. Tension?
Guys, pinagtawanan ako na. Laughing at me. Okay, any other way that we can break this is, one is pulling it apart. Tension. Guys, tension is just pulling something apart. Pulling this spaghetti until it breaks. Basta ganun hanggang napuputol siya. That's tension. The opposite of tension is compression. Compression, I'm sure it's gonna be complicated again, but basically it's just pushing together until it breaks. Ganyan. Next is shear. Shear is one of the things that I was having a problem understanding talaga until I kind of got it. Shear stress or shear force. This is a very geeky video. Okay. Okay, wag na. Guys, shear is basically this. It's tearing. That is shear. Shear is also this. Shear is also this. That's it, guys. Lastly is torsion. I don't know how they are going to describe it, but basically, torsion is just twisting until it breaks. Very, very basics. Wow. Guys, hindi na tayo mag-whiteboard. Meron na tayo iPad. When learning about all these spaghetti sticks, it's just a house. And then, this is one spaghetti, this is one spaghetti, another spaghetti, another spaghetti, another spaghetti. And then, maybe if meron pa siyang mga frame-frame dyan, all spaghettis. And pag nag-earthquake, the job of the civil engineer is just to make sure that the spaghetti holds together, that the spaghetti is strong enough. That's it. That's civil engineering or structural engineering in the most basic and rawest of forms. So now we're going to talk about the steps and the techniques that I did to turn civil engineering into spaghetti. Step one, choose a topic and study it as if you were going to explain it to a 7-year-old. It sounds simple, It is simple, but it's not easy. So how to simplify it so that a 7-year-old can actually understand it? First step of simplifying it would be to think in pictures. Whenever we do something, whenever we study something, isn't it better when we have a picture in our head? So when I was studying civil engineering and we were told to estimate a whole house, and since my father is in the construction industry, I was able to see all the steps that were required to build a house. My classmates didn't have that advantage, so nahirapan sila. Ako, basically, I can do it in one go easily, but that was because I saw it in person. Now we don't have an excuse anymore that we haven't seen it in person because of all the internet. Parang nafeel ko na, ang tanda ako na kasi that time I was studying. Wala pang internet. Anyway, best if you can see it in person. Second, if you can't, search for pictures, search for videos, search the internet and scour the internet so that you will have a picture in your head when you study. Second, use simple terms. So we have a tendency, especially when we're learning a lot of complicated stuff, whether it's engineering or accounting or being a doctor, to use very complicated terms to explain something. So if you can break it down again to something that can be understood by a child, that would mean that you also understand what you're saying. If you can simplify it, that means you don't understand it. Third is to use as ifs. So it's just like, civil engineering is like this. It's as if you are building a house with spaghetti sticks and you are making it survive earthquakes, typhoons, and whatever. So you simplify everything. Now, you won't be able to do all of these things in one go. So when you're studying, this is how it would go. I study a topic, and then I try to explain it. And then I would actually realize that there are things that I have to use hard words or things that I can't explain. And these are the times when you say, oh, this part I don't quite understand yet. So I will go back to my study material and read up again on it until I can simplify it better. And lastly, all you have to do is repeat the process until you can explain it without any gaps. Guys, I use this technique even up to this day when I read business books, when I read news articles, or just anything in general, and I sneakily do this to Chris. Love, you know, I read this book once and then this is what they said and da-da-da-da-da, and then I would realize, oh, I don't know this part yet. So I would, oh, okay, that's a gap in my knowledge that I have to go back to. You don't have to have someone to do this too. If you don't have anyone, you're just in a dorm or studying at home without anyone to actually listen to you all the time, you can pretend as if you're explaining it to someone, or you can write it down. Organize your thoughts there in plain, simple English. So guys, I hope this has been helpful to you. This is a lifelong skill, learning. I've been wearing this the whole time. Learning is a lifelong process of continuous improvement, and I feel like me reading a book every month as a habit has drastically improved me as a person, my performance, and me as Slater in general. Guys, I didn't make this technique up. It's called the Feynman technique. F-E-Y-N-M-A-N, Feynman. So thank you, Mr. Feynman. He was a scientist. And at least pag may test kayo in the future, and then tinanong ka kung kumusta yung test mo, pwede mo sabihin, hey, I'm fine, man. Anyway guys, if you like this video, click subscribe, ring the notification bell, comment if this has been helpful, and I'll see you in the next one. See you later. Slater. Bye. I don't think there's more than we can do. How come you think that I still owe